lucky in that we had a lovely company of actors led by Aidan Turner, so we hoped that the public would want to see it. But it is still a play about Irish terrorism, even though it's a comedy. So, you know, you keep your fingers crossed that people are going to enjoy it, and it seemed that they did. So I'm very, very touched that we've been nominated for one of these awards by the public.
It means that someone has gone out of their time to actually go and write my name down somewhere and vote, which is amazing. So I'm so thankful.
George was only saying the other day, actually, when it's a public vote, and that's, you know, people have taken the time to actually put our little check in the box, it means so much. So we're very, very grateful.
I was so thrilled and excited to see that Strictly Ballroom got, you know, recognised in the choreography and the costume department. It's a show that I really care about, and so seeing that the kind of, you know, the public had voted for it meant a lot to me. I was really excited by that.
It's a gift to be able to tell this story every day. And to know that it has the impact that it's had so far is, I mean, that's why you do it, you know? To know that it's affecting people is the name of the game, I guess, yeah.
But I sometimes think critics in this country don't always know how to evaluate musical theatre in quite the same way as those watching it, because it's an immersive medium. It requires you to be a part of it, and the audience is a part of it, and I think them valuing musical theatre is an extremely important part of the medium.
You go out every night, and you know that there's an audience, 1,500 people are waiting to hear this story. So the fact that now we can kind of interact with them on this level for the WhatsOnStage Awards is great.
It's such an honour. It's an absolute. I was absolutely shocked and surprised, not because you were nominated, because you're fantastic.
I was surprised.
But it's been lovely that it's been nominated for a few things. It just feels like a big kind of family celebration. It was such a special show for us.
It was such a whirlwind when we were in it. You couldn't really see out of it. It was just wherever you went, you just saw Heathers kind of taking over the world. But it's been nice to be out of it and look back and kind of see how special that job was.
I think sometimes the audience reaction can be really positive and really big, but then people go home and forget all about it. And I think this show has stayed in people's minds, and they've remembered it enough to vote for it, which is brilliant.
It's a reflection of the enjoyment perhaps that they had, and it's a comment on the experience as it was lived rather than observed by experts.
Critics still absolutely have their place in the kind of the ecology of theatre, but there's so many more opinions, and that's why awards like this are so important, I think, because they give a real kind of balanced perspective on a whole range of work.
It's so nice to know that you can keep a story intimate and rely on the bare bones of that story and reach people with it.
We wrote it at uni as like a student production for the Edinburgh Fringe, and that was the most we were expecting it was ever going to be, and so anything beyond that has just been ridiculous. And especially being nominated for an award such as this, which like awards that I like geeked out about at uni, like, oh my god, who's gonna win this year? And now to like be in the same category as like some shows that I've like idolized for years, and now to like be nominated alongside them, it's something I really can't wrap my mind around.
Voting is now open.
Vote, 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 vote.